Hello and welcome back to a classic circuit familiar to fans the world over. This is Monza. You can hear the cars ready to go. Certainly the fans are ready for some action. We're all set, so let's get this Formula 2 race underway. Monza is situated 12 miles northeast of Milan. It's 3.6 miles long and offers 11 corners. Seven of those are chicanes, putting a premium on good braking stability and traction. With a good slipstream plus the two DRS zones available, there should be a number of good passing opportunities on offer. Turn one at Monza is famous, or should I say infamous, for serious contact and incidents, especially on the opening lap. What are your thoughts on that, Davide?
Yes, this chicane is a tricky one. A lot of time you see the more experienced drivers hold back from full throttle to keep themselves safe as everyone tries to squeeze into the racing line after the opening straight.
Let's take a look at the grid position.
Final lap of the race.
Thank you.
Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
So as they climb out of the Carlin team are ready and waiting to celebrate a thoroughly deserved win. So, Davide, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
I think they kept a cool head. That's why they won today. Smooth, steady, everything back that happened to them, they handled it calmly and professionally. That's what let them focus on getting the best out of everything else. The car, the strategy, they managed to keep out of trouble the whole way around.
As we can see, it's time for the podium, and I can see the Carlin team underneath our commentary box going crazy as their driver walks out. It was a great win, and it means a great deal to this team. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the drivers' challenge. It's a good result for Yuki Tsunoda, who extends his advantage at the top of the championship. And now, Valsecchi, let me ask you, who is your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Felipe Dr...
here in Russia, today's race is about to start. We're at the Sochi Autodrome, and the drivers on the grid are almost ready to begin. Join us as we enjoy today's Formula 2 event. The Sochi Autodrome is a 3.6-mile circuit encompassing venues built for Russia's 2014 Olympics. Close barriers will make overtaking difficult in places, and much of the track can be taken flat out. The fans definitely won't be left wanting when it comes to the spectacle of sheer speed. With me at Sochi for the Russian event is Davide Valsecchi. This is a long and complex circuit. Davide, what are your thoughts heading into it?
Hi, Alex. Yeah, you're right. This is still a very exciting circuit. Not those winding turns and high-speed straights. The racing here should be extremely close from start to finish. I think we'll see a great race today, and I can't wait to get underway.
Let's look at the grid order for today's race while the cars make their final preparations. A fantastic effort from Yuki Tsunoda yesterday puts him on pole position. And starting alongside is Sean Gallet. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Deruvala, Tictum, Guan Yu Zhou, and Lundgaard, Ilott, Schumacher, Piquet, Mark.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
Thank you.
final lap of the race. Over. Take care of the car on the way in.
Carlin have pulled off a sublime performance to secure the top step of the podium today. Davide, what do you think made the difference here?
This race, this week, was about one thing and one thing only. Consistency. Anyone can be quick for just one lap, but there's a difference between that and being quick every lap, over and over and over. If you can do that, if you can gain ground when your opponents make mistakes, but then not make mistakes on your own, you can just push and push.
And there you have it, today's winners, having raised some of the biggest names in F1 today, Carlin have once again shown their expertise when it comes to recruiting new talent. No doubt today's winners have a bright future ahead of them. They certainly deserve it after today's performance. After this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. It's a good result for Yuki Tsunoda, who extends his advantage at the top of the championship. Now then, Davide Valsecchi, who would you say was your driver of the day?
Difficult call, but I say Felipe Drugovic. He was committed the entire race, and it's paid off with the result.
After all this drama, you'll be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.
Thank you.
We're moments away from lights out here at Marina Bay. A demanding circuit awaits the drivers, and we're hoping that all that preparation pays off for the win today. Located in the heart of Singapore's Marina Bay, this bumpy street circuit is seen as one of the most physically demanding in motorsport. It can be a particularly technical circuit to navigate, one that has proved popular with fans and drivers alike. As we await the start of another hugely anticipated Formula 2 race, I'm joined again by Davide Valsecchi. Davide, as a former GP2 champion, we get some insight to what is running through these young drivers' heads as they sit out on the grid.
Ciao, Alex. It's a pleasure to be here. They are nervy moments. There is no doubt about them. Mental strength is the key to remaining calm and focusing on the upcoming race. Formula 2 is so competitive, and all of these drivers know that they are going to be pushing each other all of the way. In this sport, you have to be able to control your nerves.
We are nearly ready for the start of today's race, but in the meantime, let's take a look at the grid. A fantastic effort from Christian Lundgaard yesterday puts him on pole position, and it's Marcus Armstrong in P2.
lap, final lap of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
A great win then for the ART team today. Tell me, Davide, what was the key to this success?
It was down to one thing, consistent pace over everyone else out there on the track. We spent a great deal of time talking about ways and gyro strategy, what has occurred on the track, but at the end of the day, the difference here was down to simply being faster on track than everyone else. Amazing skill on show.
An amazing race today, and a very well-deserved one too. The team worked very hard to get exactly the right setup out of the F2 car. It works for them. And the results speak for themselves. ARTGP winners today. And now let's take a look at the driver's stand. The lead at the top has come down after a poor result for our points leader. And so, driver of the day then, Davide Valsecchi, who do you think you'd go for?
Let's give it to Felipe Drugovic. That was a quality drive from start to finish. He can be proud of that one.
After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you there. Take care.